I always enjoy Tuesdays. In fact, we're going to be joined by Steve Millington in just a little under half an hour from the Twin Falls County Republican Party. One of my favorite what you'd call guests when it comes to somebody who doesn't mind, well, he says what he thinks. And that's a great thing in talk radio. Also coming up, Raul Labrador appeared last night on Sean Hannity's program on Fox News Channel. Some details on the way with that. That may be a hint that he may be up to, well, he may have a new role coming when all of this shakes out in the House of Representatives with a new leadership team, as, of course, Speaker John Boehner is retiring and leaving in a matter of a few weeks. But I wanted to open the program today and just mention some things that this has been the topic du jour in this community now for several months. It seems we're not going to get away from it anytime soon. Pastor Shahram Haydian speaking last night in Twin Falls. He's speaking in Jerome tonight on this issue, this matter. And then he has an appearance again tomorrow night in Twin Falls. We'll talk a little bit more about where he is scheduled and when he is scheduled coming up in just a few minutes. But a caller yesterday referenced some of the media coverage that's been going on aside from this radio station, which we are really the only contrarian voice in media, both on the local level and it seems nationally when it comes to this issue. And the caller referenced an editorial in the local newspaper at magicvalley.com on Sunday. And what I did is I had printed it out yesterday. I did not have a chance to sit down and delve into it because we had a relatively busy schedule during the course of the show yesterday. What I have done is taken this, and I thought today would be a good time to open the program with it. And I've highlighted a few things that I think tell us that sometimes the people who write these editorials need to be asking some questions, not so much of us, but really of themselves. And I'm not here to bash the people who work there today. They obviously disagree. They have a different point of view on this. So I will try. I make no guarantees. I will try not to be too terribly sarcastic as I go through all of this. And I realize that the people who are working in that industry are working much harder than they used to. I can remember reading a biography written by Russell Baker when I was a young man. He was a columnist for many, many years with the New York Times and syndicated as well. And he had started his newspaper career at the Baltimore Sun. And then he moved to the Times and he said he was shocked to see that there were just people sitting around not doing anything. So he asked one of the editors, what's going on? And the editor says, well, just in case something happens, they're available. You can't do that in modern media anymore. The cost and the competition you have, it's a dog-eat-dog world. So people are doing a lot, and they're doing more than they were ever asked to before. I understand all of that, and I'm not going to criticize it. And some of the newspaper stories last week that appeared in the newspaper out of Boise were actually written by one of the reporters here. So there's a lot of shared services going on. It's no different in broadcasting. Radio and TV are doing the same thing. However, there is still a huge gulf between what many of us believe, and I just look at some of the things that appear in mainstream media and think, how can they come up with that? So I've highlighted a few lines. Refugees, the writer says, are hardly a strain on the schools. Services for them account for just 0.43% of the school district's $45 million budget. Now, we've had people tell us that because of the language barriers and other things that are going on throughout the state of Idaho, and perhaps it's not being picked up by your local school district, there's an omission. It may be picked up by state government, which means taxpayers across the state would pick up these programs. So yes, it may not have a huge impact on the local school budget, but the local schools are spending, because that money may be coming in from elsewhere. So an omission in some churches is called a lie. I'm not saying anyone's lying here. I'm just saying that you can't cherry pick everything for your argument. If you claim to be, you know, objective, you've got to come up with some other matters, other part of discussion here. But here it says, yet they're model students with exceptionally high graduation rates. Now, if I sat down today and said, all Muslims are terrorists, that would be a horrible generalization, wouldn't it now? Because they aren't. So you could say some. You can't even say many. You'd have to say some. You could say likely more terrorists among Muslims than Christians. I think that that's probably a fair statement. Even Bill Maher makes that statement on his TV program every week, and he's a fellow traveling liberal. But I can't make that statement because it's not true. There are some people out there who simply are not terrorists who are practicing that faith. So it would be wrong, and you shouldn't do it. Yet to say they're all model students, and this is what this is saying, yet they're model students. Well, some of them may not be. So there you go. Some of them may not be. You can't make a blanket statement like that. And then the writer goes on to say they're not causing trouble. Well, according to whom? We had a member of the local sheriff's department in studio with us a couple of weeks ago saying sometimes we have to respond to calls, people are from other cultures who believe that it's okay to hit their wives because it was where they came from, and we have some issues with that. So, yes, there have been issues. Can I also note, we had a member of that very same sheriff's department tell me a few months ago, he was sent to a conference in Los Angeles on terrorism. When I asked him some questions about it, and this was off air, but I said, how much of it dealt with Islamic terrorism? And he said, all of it. So once again, somebody at the newspaper is omitting all of that when they decide to, and then they go on to say, well, the crime is statistically insignificant. Well, I don't know who you're talking to, pal, but I'll tell you what, I've heard some other reports from people, including some who work over at this county office building a few blocks from our studios. The writer goes on to say these aren't opinions or anecdotes. They're indisputable facts backed by hard numbers. In other words, what they're telling you is what the left always likes to say. It's settled science. There's no such thing as settled science. Heck, we've got a doctor in here every week who's been pointing out that it's good to eat butter now. Stay away from margarine. We were told for many, many years you shouldn't eat butter and eggs. Now you can eat them. There's no settled science out there. And this is what these people are trying to tell you. The argument is settled, therefore. They go on to say, well, you know, Christians have a hard time living with the Constitution, too, because they don't believe in abortion. Well, some Christians do, unfortunately. But again, the Supreme Court ruling on that decision, they have judicial review in this country, and at some point, the Supreme Court could say, hey, Roe was wrong, and we'll turn it all back over to the states. And when they say, you know, that Islam is no more dangerous to the Constitution than Judaism, they're saying ham is sold in stores, pork is sold in local stores. Of course it is. Constitution doesn't tell you what you can sell in a grocery store. Now does it? So some of these arguments are just plain spurious. Here we've got another one. The writer says business leaders have openly worried that the mounting hate speak will scare away new companies looking to invest in the Magic Valley. Name them. Who are these business people? Please, name them. Well, you haven't. Speaking of settled science, the writer says the debate about facts is over and now we must act. And the writer goes on to say it's about who we are as residents, as people, and we simply cannot allow hate to prevail. Who we are. We. Who's we? Number two, there was a video someone sent me this morning. I posted it at our KLIX Facebook page. It's from Pamela Geller's website. She keeps an eye on all of these things, but I pointed out there's a video where a Ukrainian woman explains she was traveling across Europe, but because she had studied and lived for a time in the Middle East, she understands Arabic, and she's telling the stories about these so-called refugees, the migrants, mainly men, healthy between 18 and 45, who were on the trains, bullying their way onto the trains, and speaking in Arabic to each other. They were talking about potentially raping her and other women on the train because, well, you know, these women were just dogs. They weren't wearing their headscarves. And they were also talking about robbing the Europeans that they encountered. Great. There are videos like this that are coming out of Europe left and right. United Kingdom Independence Party, known as UKIP, has put together a whole series of all of the riots and the brawls, everything else that's going on in all of Europe's major cities. You don't have to look very hard to find that. And unlike the old days of newspapering, you don't have to go down and dig through file after file after file in some fifth-floor office. You just go to Google and you put that in and you hit search and bang, there it is, all you need. 8:16, Bill Colley with you on Top Story on News Radio 1310, KLIX and NewsRadio1310.com. A fellow writing at Real Clear Politics says, if you're a liberal, you're done debating. And he goes on to say, this is a guy by the name of David Arsani. He said, when a group confuses its politics with moral doctrine, it may have trouble comprehending how a decent human could disagree with its positions. And that's precisely the problem that the fellow travelers inside and outside that newspaper have with local opposition to what's going on here. We simply have not discussed, and they will refuse to listen to anybody else's arguments or the evidence that we can provide. The writer goes on to say this is probably why people confuse lecturing with debating and why so many liberals can bore into the deepest nooks of my soul to ferret out all of those motivations, but can't waste any time arguing about the issue itself. They just simply say it's hateful. There was a guy on in the comments section after that editorial in the newspaper who was saying that people who are opposed are racist. Well, the Islamic world stretches. If you're thinking, there are Muslims living all over the world, but if you're thinking about what really constitutes an Islamic world, it stretches from the eastern, or well, western side of North Africa into East Africa, then all across Southern Asia and into the Pacific Islands. So it encounters people, if you're dividing them up by race, dozens of races. So how can you sit there and say, well, it's racist to be opposed? It's got nothing to do with anybody's race. But you see, the subtlety, there's no subtlety in that. They're just trying to shift the argument because they don't have anything else to rely on right now. So they fall back to that and accuse everybody of racism. You know, when you repeat the same cliche over and over and over again, I have a neighbor who likes to say it's beer 30, as if he's clever. I've heard him say it about 100 times now. It's no longer clever. We have a caller with us. It's 8:17. You're on the air with Bill Colley on Top Story on News Radio 1310, KLIX.
Yes, morning, Bill. It's like one of our forefathers said, to argue with someone who has renounced the use of reason and whose philosophy consists in holding humanity in contempt is like administering medicine to the dead. Thomas Paine.
Thank you. Well said.
Okay, God bless.
Good quote. I enjoy hearing that. Look, if they'd like to pigeonhole all of us and claim that they know what we're thinking, we can do the same, right? Frankly, I think that they're all Satanists. They like killing babies in the womb. They support infanticide, and they don't believe in God, and they hate America. There you go. We know what they are. And that's why they're doing these things, because they want to destroy this country, and they'll start here in this valley. Isn't that the case? Let's hear them respond to that. This fellow, Hersani, who's a conservative, goes on to write, this I found at Real Clear Politics today. He says, because no one could possibly be this malicious on his own. So they blame it on you, saying that, well, you must be taking corporate money, or, you know, you must have an issue. He said, why should liberals debate a point when they can debate your imaginary sugar daddy? Why else would conservatives hate workers? Why would they bet against America? Why do they want to destroy democracy? Or maybe you favor inequality and justice, rape culture and poverty because privilege clouds your sense of decency. He says, you're not in favor of a cost-benefit analysis when it comes to climate change policy? Well, then you're anti-science. You're a skeptic, a denier, a psychopath. Why do you hate the earth? He says, don't like big government? You're a nihilist. Forget about what policy does. Watch your tone. Or maybe you can't see things clearly because you're locked to the most addictive opiate imaginable, religion, which, let's face it, you probably don't properly understand or adhere to correctly. In other words, they'll tell you what Jesus meant. You don't have to go to church any longer to do that. See, the liberal has an answer for everything. And the liberal says if you don't agree with them and their self-evident truth, then obviously there's something wrong with you, or you must have been corrupted somewhere along the line. So again, I don't want to be too terribly sarcastic, but what is it the guy used to say on Dukes of Hazzard? Dipstick. He meant something else. Well, I guess you could say I'm a very large James Bond. They've had to enlarge the cabin in the Aston Martin. 8:22, Bill Colley with you on Top Story on News Radio 1310. KLIX. I'm sorry, but the new Bond films don't cut it for me. I love the humor of the old ones because he's a superhero, and let's not take it too seriously. But be serious about this. Tomorrow morning, Russell Singleton, physician assistant, going to be joining us from Tripp Family Medicine right here on News Radio 1310, KLIX and NewsRadio1310.com. Russell's going to be talking with us. Of course, his expertise is diet and you know, exercise and a number of things like that. But he really just wants to talk to you about your overall wellness. Well, I mean, ultimately, that's what it comes down to, that holistic approach to medicine. So that's going on tomorrow morning between 8:30 and 9 o'clock right here on News Radio 1310 KLIX and NewsRadio1310.com. A Better Health with Tripp Family Medicine. We do it every Wednesday, and you have an opportunity to talk to someone, a friendly voice, and perhaps get some medical advice or steered in the right direction when it comes to your health. Now, they're located, the office, Tripp Family Medicine, on Fillmore Street, directly across from the main post office here in Twin Falls. And remember, life's too short not to feel good. I'll get to my next telephone caller in just a moment, but I got to share this quickly. Daily Caller has this. Refugees get a not-so-warm welcome in this Slovak village. Or migrants. Residents in a Slovak village have almost unanimously mobilized to make sure Syrian refugees don't feel welcome as they fear Islamicization or Islamization of their community. The people of, and I believe it's pronounced Gabčíkovo, staged a vote last month where 97% of the 5,000 people who live there said they were against housing refugees in an abandoned dormitory in town. And the refugees are complaining because they say the police watch them. Well, you're newcomers. Who knows who you are? But again, 97% of the people said, no, we don't want them. We don't have that ability here. No one will allow us to turn to the public and say, all right, up or down, yes or no. So apparently democracy is dead in Twin Falls. You're up next. You're on the air with Bill Colley on Top Story.
Yes, I was watching the news last night on KMVT. They did a poll. I don't know who they, you never know who they do the poll from, but 70% of the Magic Valley did not know anything about the CSI refugee program, and 30% did. And then there was like 50% agreed with it and 20% disagreed with it. I'm going, where'd they get this poll? But the other thing is, it's talking about liberals want to go. I get this thing, libtards. What's the difference between a libtard and a retard? A retard has a brain.
Yeah, I just think that's a kind of a cruel word to use on the air. I'd probably refrain from it the next time you call. 50 right now, 825. Bill Colley with you on Top Story on News Radio 1310 KLIX and NewsRadio1310.com. I don't know if it's a scientific poll or not. If you just put, Drudge will put up a poll on his website every now and then and say, all right, he wants someone to answer it. And then the next day, the headline will be, well, 75% of people want this candidate. But it's not scientific because I can go tell all my friends, look, I'm supporting, I'll give you a name, Ted Cruz. So please support Ted with me. And then all of these people chime in. But you're not actually getting what they say. When they say scientific polling, that is, you take a representative sample of people. And I don't know that any TV stations in Idaho have the budgets. Well, one is owned by Gannett, maybe. But even Gannett is teetering because its newspaper business is a failure and they've had to split off TV from it and create a separate corporation. I know this because a friend of mine runs a Gannett TV station in Buffalo. So there you go. I was the best man at his wedding. Hope that helps out. The thing is, we do not really have anyone saying, all right, what's the public mood on this? Other than a few meetings and other than a few telephone calls to a radio talk show. No one has really made the effort to get a good read on what the public wants. But a vote, a simple vote, and I'm not talking about this one that they're trying to put together at this committee that's opposed to the refugee center. Again, I think the refugee center ultimately serves a good long-term purpose. Albeit, you've got a country right now that is still not recovered from a horrible economic downturn, and I don't know why you'd want to bring more people here and have them compete for your jobs. But, apparently liberals are all working out there or, they're ensconced in their offices over at CSI, and so they don't really care whether you have a job or not. The government's paying them, right? That's how they look at it, I'm sure. I believe if you actually put this up to a public vote, and it doesn't have to be binding, but just find out what the public thinks about it, and I'll tell you what, I think you'd be amazed. If 70% of the public hasn't even heard about it, you can't expect them. What if Limbaugh calls them low-information voters? You can't even expect them to come up with some sort of answer. This is why I think liberals are trying to destroy this country, though. They hate America. They'd like to destroy this culture because they think they're going to be able to rebuild it, just like the Khmer Rouge did in Cambodia. 50 years ago, the government changed its policy over who could come here as an immigrant, and we stopped bringing in Europeans, and we started bringing in the Third World to essentially change American culture and, of course, get more Democrats. So you can vote yourself even more races from the public treasury. There's a story, 88% of U.S. growth is going to be coming from immigrant families. And that's the liberals' dream because, self-loathing liberals hate their European ancestry, I suppose. And the parliamentary democracy bequeathed to us by it. You're up next. You're on the air with Bill Colley. You're on Top Story, in fact, on News Radio 1310 KLIX and NewsRadio1310.com.
Good morning, Bill. I wonder, in regards to that, the poll, I've noticed that a lot of the information from the paper is really just about the refugee program rather than the Syrian refugee group that's coming in.
Well, we had to bring in people after the Iraqi war, the policemen who helped us out, whose lives were in danger, all of those people. we've got to resettle those people, because otherwise your word's no good around the world any longer.
Right, and I think the college and the paper, whoever's using, you know, defending the program, they're saying the refugee program. So they're playing with words here, where a lot of the problem isn't the refugees that come in. There's been a lot of benefit from that. I think the Syrian issue is what they're dodging when they talk about this. And I think that's how they're trying to bring public opinion to their side.
It comes back to an argument we were having earlier on about this debate. Thank you for the call. Comes back to the argument, who are these people? And to sit there and say, oh, there's a serious vetting process, which is what that editorial said. Your own government disputes that. Your own government, your governor here in Idaho disputes that. He said it here on the air last week. You know, normally when Governor Rotter makes an appearance with me on the show, there's a guy who writes a column over at that newspaper who quotes him, mentions what he talked about, and it ends up getting picked up by newspapers across the Northwest. One time, AP even picked it up, and it ended up in a newspaper. I happen to see it online in Mississippi. The governor here last week said, we've got to suspend this program, put a moratorium on it till we figure out who all of these people are. Nobody has picked up that conversation he had with me. Yeah, I know. Look who we're dealing with. Steve Millington is coming up next. He's the chairman of the Twin Falls County Republican Party. Going to talk a little John Boehner and what we may see following Boehner's departure, Republican leadership.